evening. They are bona fide agents of Pakistan. And today, the NIA's terror trail has finally caught up with the Hurriyat. Based on an investigation that was first put out by this channel, the NIA has arrested seven of the top leaders of the Hurriyat, which includes people who are extremely close to both Syed Ali Shah Gilani as well as to Mirwais Omar Farooq. NIA sources say they could be next in line. These two men, Mirwais Omar Farooq and Syed Ali Shah Gilani, could be arrested next. The FIR details the money trail, money that was taken from the likes of Hafiz Saeed and the Jamaat-ud-Dawah, and how using Hawala operators and cross-LOC traders, the Hurriyat has used this money to instigate terrorists and stone pelters in the valley. Is it time to call out this duplicity once and for all? Call the separatists what they are, terrorists, period. That's our big focus. It's time for Face Off. Seven top leaders of the Hurriyat, Altaf Fanoush, Bitta Karate, Naeem Khan, among others, arrested after a CNN News 18 investigation. The NIA says more arrests are likely. Mirwais and Gilani under the scanner. Hurriyat uses Pakistan's money to foment trouble in the valley, all in the name of a distorted Azadi. And we'll be putting those questions to our guest panelists who will be joining us later tonight. GBL Narasimha Rao, BJP spokesperson, Lieutenant General Shankar Prasad, former DG Infantry, Dr. Ajoy Kumar, spokesperson of the Congress, Gauhar Gilani, political commentator, joining us from Srinagar tonight, Shabnam Loan, senior lawyer here in Delhi, and Ashok Pandit, film director, will be joining us on our Talking Point panel. We'll get to our debate and to our debaters in just a couple of minutes. Here are the other headlines that we are tracking this Monday night on Face Off. India should not be under any illusions about Doklam, says China's defense ministry, while the foreign ministry does not shut the door completely on a possible bilateral between NSA Ajit Doval and his Chinese counterpart. It is the richest civic body in the country. The BMC has spent 11,000 crores over the last 5 years, but year after year, it's the same story. Potholes spring up after a short burst of rain. The mayor says the media is overblowing the issue, despite at least one death because of potholes. The officers of the CBI, Income Tax Department, the National Disaster Response Force, among those hit in a massive fire at the Lok Nayak Bhavan in central Delhi. No casualties reported as search operations continue. And they may have lost the final at Lord's, but it's been an all-round applause back home for the Indian women's cricket team. Tributes pour in from the Prime Minister and top cricketers. The BCCI will felicitate the players and states announced big cash awards. But up first, the news is tightening. Beyond just warnings and raids by different agencies, beyond show-cause notices, the National Investigation Agency today arrested seven Hurriyat conference functionaries for money laundering and for terror funding. CNN News 18's own investigations and exposés have frequently shown up these separatists as anti-India stooges who are funding terror in India as Pakistan's proxies. First, the day's story. It's a big CNN News 18 impact after an investigation that was put out on this channel back in May. After this report, we'll get straight to our debate and to our debaters.
Just three of the seven Hurriyat Conference saber rattlers put behind bars today, all close associates of the outfit's hawkish chief, Syed Ali Shah Gilani. And the noose closes in around terror mongers, inciters, funding agents, active breeders of hate in the Kashmir Valley. They'll appear before a Delhi court tomorrow.
Evidence which has been collected so far that clearly proves the financial trail as well as the direct link between the terror activities and the funding of terror activities.
The case against the seven is down in black and white. At the top, the separatists named in the same breath as terror mastermind Hafiz Mohammed Saeed. They acted in connivance with terrorists of the Hizbul Mujahideen, Lashkar-e-Taiba and Dukhtaran-e-Millat, collecting funds for separatist and terrorist activities in Jammu and Kashmir, for pelting stones on security forces, burning down schools, waging war against India. CNN News 18's own investigation on the Hurriyat using Hawala routes for terror funding finding prominent mention in the FIR. The critical unveiling of documents on Syed Ali Shah Gilani's massive tax defaults, the trial leading to his son-in-law Altaf Fantoush. And CNN News 18's Operation Jihadi Badam on commodity trade across the LOC diverted to terror. The terror-trader-separatist nexus. The impact of these exposés holds out promise of justice against the proxies of terror.
This network of funding has to be stopped, has to be stopped. If you stop this funding, the anti-national activities you see will come down, will peter out. Right. Because these anti-national activities are happening only because of the funding.
The separatist bigwigs have even given a strike call for tomorrow, calling the arrests revengeful and arbitrary. These are people long funded by Pakistan to bleed India. Pak proxies exposed. Is it time to brand separatists as terrorists? The debate tonight on Face Off at 9.
All right, let's call a spade a spade. Seven arrests have been made by the NIA after an investigation that was first put out here on CNN News 18. Is it time to remove these veneers, to remove this facade, this whole curtain calling the Hurriyat separatists and secessionists? They are terrorists. The NIA FIR details the money trail as to how they have gotten money from Pakistan and used it to fund and foment terrorist activities and stone pelting activities in the valley. Joining us on our panel tonight, G.V.L. Narasimha Rao, spokesperson of the BJP, Dr. Ajay Kumar, spokesperson of the Congress, Lieutenant General Shankar Prasad, former DG Infantry, Gauhar Gilani, political commentator, joining us from Srinagar, Shabnam Lohan, senior lawyer, and Ashok Pandit, film director. G.V.L. Narasimha Rao, I've got the NIA FIR with me. It mentions how the Hurriyat Conference members have been taking money from proscribed organizations like the Jamaat-ud-Dawah and internationally proscribed terrorists like Hafiz Mohammed Saeed and from other terrorist organizations like the Hizbul Mujahideen, the Dukhtaran-e-Milat and the Lashkar-e-Toyba for raising, receiving and collecting funds through illegal means, including Hawala, for funding separatist and terrorist activities in Jammu and Kashmir. Shouldn't we call the separatists by the name that they deserve to be called with, and that is terrorists? They are funding and fomenting terrorist activities in the valley. They should be called terrorists.
Absolutely, Zaka. They are the real troublemongers, troublemakers in Kashmir. Far from being people who are fighting for any democratic rights of Kashmiris, they are actually running a racket in the name of some kind of democratic protest. They are, I think, more than terrorists. I would call them Pakistani stooges and Pakistani poodles who are actually out to really create unrest in their own home state for the sake of earning money. I think it's nothing but a mercenary activity being carried out by merciless stooges of Pakistan for earning money.
Why then stop at the mercenaries? Why not go after the big fish? Why not go after Syed Ali Shah Gilani? Why not go after Mirwais Umar Farooq? If today the people who've been picked up are closely associated with these big fish, then why are you sparing the big fish?
No, Zaka, I think we are not like a sham democracy, a sham government like Pakistan. I think even these arrests have happened after gathering clinching evidence against these people. I think they are now under arrest. Let there be custodial interrogation of these people. Let clinching evidence also be gathered about all other players who have been acting as the front men for Pakistan, and they will meet their they will also face the same kind of end.
Gauhar Gilani, how do you look at the men who've been arrested today? Shahidul Islam was the Mirwais's personal secretary for 20 years. Are you telling me the Mirwais had no idea what his personal secretary for 20 years was up to? Altaf Fantoush is Syed Ali Shah Gilani's son-in-law. He's the one who's married to Syed Ali Shah Gilani's daughter. Are you telling me he didn't know what his son-in-law was up to? Bitta Karate has been caught on camera admitting to receiving money from Pakistan. None of these people, the so-called top leadership of the Hurriyat Conference, knew what their underlings were up to. How do you justify this, Gauhar Gilani?
First of all, Zaka, I'm not here as a, you know, I do not hold brief for the Hurriyat conference. But since you have asked the question, I would like to reply. And my reply is that in 1953, on August 9, 1953, even the great Sheikh, Sheikh Mohammed Abdullah, the Prime Minister of Jammu and Kashmir, was unceremoniously removed as Prime Minister and arrested by Jawaharlal Nehru's on Jawaharlal Nehru's orders. And then he also was accused of taking money from Pakistan. So this has been happening here in Kashmir for the last 7 decades.
Gawar,
but if there
Gawar,
is any
you
truth
saw
in
the
these
unrest
allegations
that happened
by
that
NIA, please let me allow.
Let me complete, Zaka. For the better
let
part
me
of the last 8 months or so was done under instructions by these men from money that's taken from the likes of a Hafiz Mohammed Saeed, and you're comparing him to Sheikh Abdullah? I mean,
let me
really,
complete
Gawar.
My sentence. Let me complete my sentence. There is a section of population in Jammu and Kashmir who want transparency from the Hurriyat conference. If you follow social media, there is a section of population of Jammu and Kashmir, especially the youth, who are asking tough questions of the Hurriyat conference, and they also want to know the truth. What if there is any criminality involved?
So
people will not
why
Kashmir
are you
is a
not
vibrant
why
society.
Are you not asking
it will
those
not
questions,
tolerate
Gawar?
Any criminality.
You represent,
but it does
no,
not
Gawar,
mean that
you
the political
you represent,
sentiment in Jammu
you
and Kashmir
represent
for
the
right
young
to
people in Kashmir
is not indigenous.
Why are you shying away from asking those questions? Why are you apologizing on behalf of the Hurriyat?
You know, I'll tell you why.
Or appearing as an apologist for the Hurriyat.
I'll tell you why. Because, four days ago, the Indian Army killed a 60-plus-year-old man in cold blood. You did not do any program. Then they mowed down a young girl, a minor student. You did not do any program.
And that justifies taking money from the Jamaat-ul-Dawah. That justifies taking money from Hafiz Saeed. That justifies instigating stone pelters in the valley. That justifies shutting schools for 6 months straight.
And
I mean,
I have no problem.
I find it amazing.
You just said,
Gohar, there are young
he
people in Kashmir
no
who are
problem.
Asking questions of the Hurriyat conference. I wish you asked those same questions of the Hurriyat conference. Let me bring in Ashok Pandit. I want to expose tonight the sheer hypocrisy of the likes of the Hurriyat conference.
Yeah,
Do you know? Gohar Gilani and Shabnam Lone will not acknowledge this fact,
but you
or
not do any program.
The fact is that since July of last year till February March of this year, 235 school days were lost to a Hurriyat imposed shutdown in the valley, and the sons and grandsons and granddaughters of these Hurriyat people. They are studying in universities in Australia. They are studying in universities in the United States. So the poor man's son and daughter can face 235 days of a school shutdown, Ashok Pandit. But Gilani's sons and grandsons and the other Hurriyat people's sons and grandsons will study in Melbourne and in New York.
Zaka, today is a very important day for Kashmiri Pandits. One where we are all sad because the Supreme Court has rejected our plea to take on the terrorist organizations who have killed Kashmiri Pandits. But we will approach the President for that now. And on the other side, we applaud the government, the Narendra Modi government, for breaking the back of Hurriyat today. It is for the first time where such senior Hurriyat leaders have been arrested and they are brought to Delhi and they will be put behind the bars. So there's a confidence to the locals of Kashmir, not Gilanis and Shabnam Lones, who have been very indirectly supporting the Hurriyat leaders, not openly, but they're trying to be with them. Having said that, I think it was very important which you as a channel did. You as a channel exposed the money trail of this funding of these Hurriyat leaders who have become richer and richer every day. Nobody used to pose questions to them that from where they used to get money. They had palatial houses, they had number of cars, they enjoyed their lives at the cost of a common Kashmiri who was always being on a death threat on the streets. So they are responsible for the killings of everybody in Kashmir, whether it is security forces, whether it is a common Muslim, whether it is a common Kashmiri Pandit, or whether it is a common Sikh or a Ladakhi or a Jammu.
Shabnam Lohan, isn't this a fair question to ask? Where are the likes of a Gilani getting money to buy bungalows in South Delhi? Where are they getting money to buy bungalows in Srinagar? I mean, now the NIA says this is money that's coming in from Hafiz Saeed. This is money that's coming in from Jamaat-ud-Dawah. So they're happy to use that money to fund and foment trouble in the valley, to ensure that kids of ordinary Kashmiris don't go to school. 235 school days are lost, but their kids study in Melbourne and in New York.
Okay, Zaka, I'll be candid and honest. I'll answer your questions, but you are my host and I expect you to listen to me. I never sit with Ashok Pandit in any program because he is a communal heckler who has a habit of getting personal with people.
You leave the show and don't humiliate me. You don't humiliate me, you leave the show.
Okay.
You leave the show, the show is not yours.
Leave the show?
So you leave the show and leave the chair.
Hang on.
Don't humiliate a victim of terrorism like this.
One second.
Who are you to tell me?
No,
Zaka, should I leave the show?
No. One second. My point is, I've asked. Let's focus on the issue. Let's not get personal.
Zaka, should I leave the show?
Let's not get personal, please. My appeal to both of you, please.
This is what I tell you.
No, my appeal to both of you. My appeal, very humble appeal to both Shabnam Lohan and
Ashok
Pandit.
Because I've got great regard for you, Zaka.
My humble appeal.
That is why I am sitting.
My humble appeal.
Now, if I have to listen to him, should I leave the program?
Let's not get personal. Let's address the issue. Let's answer the question.
Fine.
I asked, Shabnam.
Okay. Now, yes, Zaka, like many Kashmiris today, I am very honest with this regard that if the government has evidence that the Hurriyat has got crores and crores of rupees in funding, and let me say, if the Hurriyat has been saying throughout that we are a political organization and we believe that Kashmir should get independence, fine. But if they got these funds for those widows, for those orphans, every Kashmiri will ask them this question, where is that money? It was supposed to go for a philanthropic cause. And if Hurriyat leaders have assets which are beyond their sources of income, the law should take its own course. Having said that, I have a question for the esteemed panel. Can I just put these facts out?
Give me 30 seconds. Let me put these facts out. I've already said 235 school days, that's about 8 months of school days, were lost between July 2016 and February of this year. 16,000 crores was lost because of halted economic activity by a shutdown imposed by the Hurriyat on the people of Kashmir. 78 people have been killed. Over 5,000 security personnel have been injured in the stone pelting. 66 weapons, including 17 AK-47 rifles, have been looted by the terrorists. Over 7,000 rounds of ammunition were looted by the terrorists. Shouldn't the Hurriyat, Shabnam Lohan, answer for this? Isn't it the right of every ordinary Kashmiri citizen to ask these questions to the Hurriyat?
Yes. Yes, great statistics, Zaka, but there's one thing. A person, a fair person like you, you omitted one thing, that there were hundreds, 150, 200 civilians who got killed. There were so many children who got blinded. You omitted this. Now, I as a Kashmiri, what do I want? Well, I want our young men to choose life over death. I want our young men to dream. I want our young men to soar high. But there's one thing. You cannot allow your own security forces. You cannot allow the army to become a killing machine.
I take objection to that. That is incorrect. That is complete misrepresentation.
You cannot allow. I find it amazing
that both Shabnam Lohan and Gaur Gilani are saying that young Kashmiris are asking questions of the Hurriyat, but they are continuing to almost apologize for the Hurriyat. I don't know why. I don't know why the Hurriyat has this sort of overhang over both Shabnam Lohan and with Gauhar Gilani. Why are you appearing as an apologist for the Hurriyat? Let me bring in Dr. Ajoy Kumar. Let me bring in Dr. Ajoy Kumar. Let me bring in General Prasad.
Political struggle for right to self-determination in Jammu and Kashmir.
Please. Your political struggle cannot be funded by Pakistan. Your political struggle cannot be funded at the cost of young Kashmiri kids losing 235 days of schoolwork. I'm sorry. That political struggle has no meaning, no relevance, no resonance to the ordinary Kashmiri people if it's at the cost of 235 school days.
Will you listen to my argument or you will keep on saying?
Your arguments, I'm willing to buy your arguments, but you're coming across as an apologist for the Hurriyat. I don't know why, you're coming across as an apologist for the Hurriyat.
Give me 30 seconds.
No, let me also bring in Ajoy Kumar and Shankar Prasad.
Let me bring in Ajoy Kumar and General Prasad.
One second. I'll come back to you, Gauhar. Ajoy Kumar, is this a drawing of the line in the sand? Is this FIR? And let's be clear about this. Such senior levels of Hurriyat leadership have not been arrested in the past. These are people who've been working with Mirwais. I just gave the Shahidul Islam example. He's been Mirwais's personal secretary for 20 years. Altaf Fantoush is Syed Ali Shah Gilani's son-in-law. At this level, arrests have not happened in the past. Do you believe that this is a sign from the Modi government that they are going to change course? And this course is going to be to expose the Hurriyat, to lay out their naked agenda out there for everybody to see, including ordinary Kashmiris?
Look, first of all, Zaka, like correctly said, you know, in 1953, where the BJP keeps taking pot shots at Pandit Nehru, but he put Sheikh Abdullah, who was such a tall leader, because he was pushing for the separate or pushing for the Kashmiri independence. And then he was in the longest period of time, if I remember historically, I think it is closer to 12 years or 16 years or so. Nearly closer to 16 years, I think, if my history is right, was under house arrest. But the issue is, what the Hurriyat has done is couple of, and based on the NIA evidences, and the government has the, should pursue them. First of all, I disagree with Shabnam saying that the misutilization of money is one issue. Taking money from across the border from organizations and country which is inimical to India's interest is obviously a huge crime.
Exactly.
The second issue is misuse. So I think the first primary issue is, and I think the government is definitely right on, and I think Hurriyat themselves by this action has definitely lost a huge amount of credibility. Now, my colleagues from Kashmir who have been saying the issues which are close to Kashmir, which are very close to the Kashmiri people, I think their grouse in terms of reporting or those issues may have their stand, but right now today's debate is on Hurriyat. So if we had, and without diluting that, what the government steps on the Hurriyat is correct. You shouldn't have to, very obviously, no, you took money from terrorist organization, you took from
Dr.
Pakistan,
Kumar, why did
ISI,
it take so long for these steps
against India's interest.
No, so, why did it take so long for these steps? Now, let me look at the amount of money that these fat cats have got. Salaries to personal security officers of Hurriyat people who have security, 4.96 crores. This is over a period of 2001 to 2012. Salaries of residential guards for these separatists from 2001 to 2012, 3.79 crores. Fuel, just the amount of fuel that's been spent by these people and the vehicles assigned to them, 71 lakhs. Overall expenditure for a period of 12 years is 9.37 crores. I mean, UPA was in power for 10 years. Why did you continue to brook them, Dr. Kumar? You could have very well called out the Hurriyat on the money that's coming in from Pakistan, on the terror funding that's coming in from Pakistan.
I will not answer one question. If Pandit Nehru had arrested Sheikh Abdullah, then on what basis did Indira Gandhi Sahiba release him in 1975? Why was the Indira Abdullah Accord made? Because that Kashmir conspiracy case never reached to its logical conclusion. There was lot of evidence against Sheikh Abdullah.
Okay.
But it is the Congress government who released him. And you need to answer.
So can I come
in?
Yeah, okay, Ajay Kumar, let him respond.
Let
him respond. Let him respond.
First, couple of things. First of all, first things first. Zaka, when one of the new TV channels did a, and you guys did a sting operation, and that's what I think they provoked the government. So the first question is, why did the government of UPA, the NDA has been there for 3 years, why was it post a TV sting that everybody started? It was actually the actions were based on a TV sting and then the NIA came into action. If you had a TV sting during a period, would we get into action? We would have probably gotten much before it if you had evidence.
Now you're saying it's because the TV channels didn't do it. That's why we
take action.
Come on, please, Dr. Kumar, come on, please. That's a very frivolous argument. I'm sorry.
No,
I didn't expect such a frivolous argument from you.
One sec, Zaka, can I complete?
Come on, a TV channel did not expose, therefore we did not go after the Hurriyat.
I'm just saying that.
Please.
Can I?
Please, really flippant argument.
So one sec. I'm just saying that the chronology of timing. Okay, so the. Okay, but the chronology is suspicious, but let's give them the benefit of doubt. The question again is every organization, whether it's the Maoist, we went after the Maoist funding. We also went, the question is evidence. The NIA has got this evidence. They've been able to collect this evidence. The whatever be the reasons why they were able to get through various, and the intelligence. Now, if you tell me that, did I find evidence against the separatists who are working on the Nepal border and Maoists during our time, and why are they not moving? Those are arguments. Every government has their responsibilities. And I say that this
but
government on this issue, please prosecute
now.
The people. The Hurriyat is definitely based on the. I can't hear you, Rao
Saab. With them.
Say that again.
No. Your leaders have.
Yeah, that's GVL, you,
your
by
leaders
the way.
Have an.
Your My
leaders
God, you are PDP government.
Also,
GVL, PDP government. PDP government says. PDP government says talk to separatists. You are a government with the PDP, and you have the guts to tell me. Your PDP government and BJP government says talk to separatists and you have the guts to tell me. PDP and BJP government says talk to separatists and you have the guts to tell me on a TV channel. Come on, Rao Saab, have some sense. Have some sense. Your government, PDP, BJP says talk to separatists and you have the guts to tell this kind of nonsense. My friend, Mr. Rao, what has happened to you?
No, will you take
Rao
a hard line towards
your government says talk to separatists and you come on TV channel and start talking.
Will you stop having my, this romantic
Rao Saab, have some restraint. Mr. Rao, look at the kind of lies you're saying on TV. Your government says PDP, BJP government says talk to separatists. PDP government says talk to separatists. And then you deny them.
Your leaders, Manishankaraya, your leader.
What, yaar?
Your leader.
When in Rome, be like Roman. When in Delhi, talk Deshbhakti. When in Srinagar, talk to separatists. That is the BJP. Pseudo-nationalist, fraud nationalist.
Okay, one second.
To separatists.
One second, gentlemen. No, one second.
Stop that drama, man.
Hang on. I don't want this. I don't want this to descend into a political slanging match between BJP and Congress. But the fact is that this kind of crackdown. One second. You've had your say. Let me go to General Prasad, please. Let me go to General Prasad. General Prasad is waiting very patiently. General Prasad. The question that I asked to both the politicians as well, you've served in Kashmir a number of years. Do you think that this is a turning point? This kind of a crackdown on the senior echelons of the Hurriyat, have you seen this before and is this a drawing of the line in the sand? That finally people closest to Gilani and Mirwais, and we're being told by NIA sources that they could be next in line to face arrest. Do you think this is a turning point in the fight against the Hurriyat?
Thank God it has happened. Thank God somebody has taken an action. It's for decades that every single political party has ruled this country has known what's been going on. If someone today says A political party or B political party did not react, well, that's something which history will not bear them off. Every single political party who's led either Kashmir or the central government is responsible for this. Let's not go into details of it. I know it, you know it, all these people on television channel know it, that this has been going on for a very, very long time. The good thing today is, finally, after a long wait, this nation is seeing the right kind of people being arrested, because sufficient evidence has now been collected and is available. The custodial interrogation is going to begin from tomorrow. And sooner than later, a lot more names will come out. Not only these seven people, but seven more of these bosses will come out. I sincerely hope so, that this time the investigating agencies have sufficient evidence available to not only book these seven people, but all those people who are their bosses. The issue today is that every single, you know, in one of the TV debates just a couple of months or a couple of weeks ago, when I was also on the channel, somebody asked these people as to why the Hurriyat said, why don't you come and talk to us? All right, we'll talk to you. What will happen? Oh, we can control the stone pelting. What did it mean? You can control the stone pelting because you are controlling it with a regulator. If you want to increase it, you can increase it because you got the money to pay the children. And people say children have been wounded. Who wounded the children? Not the military, not the security forces. These Hurriyat people. Why did they get these children to go and throw stones at security forces when security forces are doing their legitimate task?
But Shabnam Lone and Gaur Gilani will not buy that. Shabnam Lone and Gaur Gilani will not buy that.
No, there is. That is up to them. They buy it or they don't buy it.
No, that's again part of this whole propaganda war. That is again part of this whole propaganda war.
You are lying on television and misleading 1.2 billion Indians with these lies. Are you saying
there
people will go and get killed and get pellets in their eyes if someone pays them? You are insulting the people of Kashmir. This is humiliation.
You are lying.
And this is what you want. No. This is what you want. You want to humiliate and criminalize the political opinion. I am saying Hurriyat or no Hurriyat, the sentiment is indigenous and it has sustained and it has survived for last 70 years and it will sustain. No matter what you do, we know you are worried because of China.
I can't understand. When there is, when Bitta Karate, hang on. One second.
And that's why
when Bitta Karate is caught on camera admitting, that he killed pundits, that he got money from Pakistan to do it. I don't know why are you coming across as an apologist for Bitta Karate? Why? Why are you apologizing to on his behalf? He's caught on camera, saying that he's got money to kill Kashmiri pundits.
On the war crime committed by Indian Army.
On camera, saying that he's got money from Pakistan.
You don't have guts. You are an apologist. For Indian criminal acts in Kashmir.
Zaka,
if you want me to be
an apologist for the Indian Army, I'm happy to be that. Gaur Gilani, I am happy to be an apologist for the Indian Army. I know you might find it hard to digest this. I know you might find it hard to digest this, but I'm happy to be an apologist for the Indian Army. No, you are not answering my question. You are evading my question. You are digressing from the question
I
asked you.
And has anything changed?
No, one second. One second. One second. Shabnam Lone. Shabnam Lone. Let me just play this out. Let me just play out.
You cannot.
Bitta Karate, one of the people, one of the seven who was arrested today, on camera, admitting that he killed Kashmiri pundits. On camera, admitting that he got money from Pakistan. Let me just play out 30 seconds of that clip and let me get a reaction from Shabnam Lone.
He should be. Don't let him out.
No, one sec. Let me just play that out.
अब बीसी है लगा जिसे बीसी मारे
ज़्यादा कश्मीरी पंडित थे
जी
Shabnam Lone and you think this man deserves to be out? This man deserves to have the luxurious life? Cheat Kashmiri people in the name of Azadi?
Yes. He has murdered Kashmiri pundits. This man should never have been let out. Now here is a question from me to the government of India. Why did you leave him? On what basis? Even if they say that the judge said that there is no evidence, that is wrong, Zaka. This man should never have been let out. He should have been booked repeatedly under Public Safety Act. Now this Ashok Pandit is always saying that we have supported him. It is the government who released him. It is the government who allowed him to have a good life. Now I am again saying and reiterating it on behalf of the Kashmiri Muslims. Don't leave him. Even if there is no evidence against him in the Hawala case, don't leave him. He does not represent the Kashmiri Muslim. He does not represent my ilk. He was involved in that. And Government of India, we need to have answers. What did Government of India do? Yes. You released him and you taught our young
people you want to respond to that?
It is okay to kill Kashmiri
Ashok Pandit. Pandit, you want to respond
that
to that?
It is okay to kill people and live a normal life. Sabse zyada.
Let him respond.
You let these people out.
Let him respond.
They became icons for our youth.
Let him respond. Let him respond. Ashok Pandit.
Zaka, this is very funny of Shabnam Lohan that she's coming out of big soliloquy that he should be arrested.
Who are you? Who are you? Do you represent Kashmiri Pandits?
I can also shout at you.
Can I please appeal to both of you? Please don't make this personal. Please don't. No, I'm sorry. You cannot make this personal. One second. Please, Shabnam Lohan, Ashok Pandit. My humble request to both of you. Please. My humble request. This is not about two individuals. Shabnam Lohan, one second. You said it's the government that led out Bitta Karate. Let him respond, please. Hang on. Let him respond, and I appeal again to both of you. Please, no personal attacks. Refrain from personal attacks. Ashok Pandit, respond to what Shabnam Lohan said. Why was Bitta Karate left? Why was he allowed to go scot free? One second. Ashok Pandit to respond. Ashok Pandit to respond, please. Shabnam Lohan, one second, please. You asked him a question, let him respond.
You are a fit case.
Let him please respond to the question you asked. Ashok Pandit.
Making money.
Ashok Pandit.
And then accusing the security forces.
But who let him free, Ashok Pandit? Who let him free? Why was he out for all these years? Unleashing mayhem and fear amongst the people of Kashmir.
Zaka, from the year 1990 onwards, we have been appealing, we have been shouting at the top of the voices against all the state governments and the central government that this man, Bitta Karate, has killed us and is a killer. But the apathy of the state government, all the governments and the central government played in the hands of terrorists. The Congress government nursed terrorism in Kashmir. Farooq Abdullah nursed terrorism in Kashmir. They were good friends and they are people responsible for whatever was happening in Kashmir. And then all the educated class of Kashmir, they all started supporting like what, Shabnam Lohan and Gaur Gilanis, who never say that Burhan Wani was a terrorist. The white collar terrorists in Jammu and Kashmir are also responsible for Bitta Karate to be out of the jail. There is no two opinions on that.
Okay. It's a real travesty, and you referred to this earlier on in the program as well. Today, even the Supreme Court refused to entertain a petition by Roots in Kashmir, people who are essentially fighting against this pogrom that happened against the Kashmiri Pandits back in the 1990s. But I think General Prasad wanted to respond. You wanted to come in, General Prasad. Quickly.
See, I just want to say that let's not make a political issue out of it. It's a national security problem.
Yes.
We have suffered terrorism enough. We have lost enough security personnel and enough innocent civilians. We have completely retarded the next generations of Kashmir without giving them education. They're all going to become vagabonds. Today is a time that each and every political party and each and every person who's sane must stand together and say, these are the people who are ruining Kashmir. These are the people who are ruining peace in Kashmir and the future generations of Kashmir. Look at the figures that you've given out of the losses that we have suffered.
Yes.
Time has come that the whole country must decide that these people who are perpetrating terrorism are anti-national, they're terrorists themselves. Let the law take their own course. We sincerely hope that sufficient evidence is available and custodial interrogation will
absolutely
reveal the bigger
absolutely
people who are involved
but,
in it.
Why stop with the small fish? Why stop with the small fish, Divya Narasimha Rao? Look at the kind of stuff that Shahidul Isha Gilani has said in the past. He has said, I am not by birth Indian. It's a compulsion. Despite numerous warnings, G.V.L. Narasimha Rao, Syed Ali Shah Gilani hoisted Pakistani flags in the Kashmir Valley.
He can go to Pakistan.
So why are you not arresting such a man?
To go to Pakistan.
Why are you not arresting such a man?
Let him get out of here. If he doesn't like to be here, let him get out. We will buy him a ticket. We will drop him off the LOC. We can just drop him across the LOC. We will throw him out. Let him go. He doesn't have to live here. But entire Kashmir belongs to India. Whether you like it or not, that's not going to change. I think you by acting as a stone pelter on television, you're not going to really make it up for separatists. Their game is up, and people like you who are apologists for these Kashmiri separatists, I think they have to pack their bags or leave this country or land up in Tihar jail. There is no third place for them.
Okay, I'm going to get a round of closing comments. Shabnam Lone, Gaur Gilani. Why should such a man be tolerated when he says, I'm not Indian by birth, it's by compulsion? He calls Pakistan a well-wisher, India an occupying force. I mean, if he doesn't want to live in this country, he's free to leave, like GVL said.
I think, from United States, which has a position on Kashmir that it's a disputed territory, Iran has a position that it's a disputed territory, Turkey has a position that it's a disputed territory, so has China. They have
absolutely
offered mediation.
No,
so let's
matter.
Not fool ourselves. It's a dispute, well, internationally recognized dispute. And if you have, Zaka, I pity if you, a person of your caliber and your stature will say that Kashmir is not a dispute, then I'm sorry, there's no point debating it.
No,
entire
but,
world
but
knows
it,
that
no,
Kashmir
no,
is
it's another thing
it's
entirely. It's another thing
so
entirely to
territory.
Say,
let's
I'm
it.
Not an Indian
China,
by birth, I'm an Indian by compulsion.
Part, India is
if you're so feeling compelled,
come on,
if you're feeling
it.
So compelled, why did Syed Ali Gilani had such a problem with being Indian,
yeah,
he's saying by birth I'm not Indian,
like
I'm compelled to be Indian.
Persons.
Why did he ask for an Indian passport?
All these things.
Why did he ask for an Indian passport? When he wanted to travel to Saudi Arabia to meet his daughter, he asked for an Indian passport. Why did he want an Indian passport? Why did he apply for an Indian passport if he's feeling so compelled about his Indianness?
Why did Subhash Chandra Bose go to meet Hitler and to seek his help?
No, no, I'm asking you a straight question. If Syed Ali Shah Gilani is so ashamed, of his Indianness, why did he ask for an Indian passport? When he wanted to go and visit his daughter some years ago in Saudi Arabia because she was suffering from a terminal illness, then he wanted the Indian state. Then he wanted the Indian passport.
Read Indian freedom struggle and see what Subhash Chandra Bose did.
Come on. I'm sorry, Gohar. I'm sorry.
He traveled in South Africa.
I'm sorry that you are apologizing for a man like Syed Ali Gilani. That's what I feel sad about. That's what I feel sad about, that you are coming across as somebody who's apologizing for someone like Syed Ali Shah Gilani.
I don't care what a media
all right.
which has a bias.
Zaka, Ajay Kumar, last word to you.
About that opinion.
Last word to you, Ajay Kumar, last word.
Zaka.
30 seconds. I've got to wrap up. Yeah.
Zaka, the issue is Kashmir is not a Kashmir, it will never be. Kashmir status of Kashmir is never disputed. They passed the sign, they're part of the Indian Union. They said that they may have
a
special status, but they're part of the Indian Union. So that debate is over and gone. The question again, no, one second, can I complete, sir? I didn't interrupt you. The question again, sir, is that you agree to be a special status. Sir, can I, Ghafoor sir, can I just complete the under. you signed as a special status as a part of the Indian constitution, so that status, so there's no question of dispute. The second question is, I would request my colleagues like Ashok Pandit, you know, not to
accession.
The fight
that's
against this is so huge
accession.
Don't score
that's
political don't score political
let
points
let you
Binta
also
made an
that
interview and
Mr.
Nehru Ashok Pandit
May
2017
that
he can
dismiss
the
BJP government. So Mr. Ashok Pandit,
he made an interview in May 2017.
Your people have been burning, or your people have been burning, Shabnam Lohan. I mean, you're still stuck in 1948 plebiscite and this and that. Okay, I'm going to wrap up. I'm going to wrap up. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. The debate has had to wrap up in such a category. So that's it. Time out. Time out. Thank you. Thank you. I'm going to wrap up. I'm sorry that it had to wrap up on such a cacophonous note. But all I'll say is this: I feel really sad and I feel really sorry that a man like Saeed Ali Gilani, whose hypocrisy has been laid out on this program, whose hypocrisy has been laid out by the NIA, he says he's compelled of his Indianness, he's ashamed of his Indianness, but he wants an Indian passport, a document given by the Indian state to go meet his daughter when his daughter is ill. I'm sorry that young people and bright minds like Gaur Gilani are coming across as apologists for such a man. All I hope is that there have been crackdowns in the past as well against Hurriyat functionaries. I hope that this doesn't stop at the small fry. I hope that this goes right up to the top. This goes right up to the leadership of the Hurriyat, and they're exposed in a way that should have been done a very, very long time ago. I'm going to take a break. If you've been tuned into this debate and if you're still interested in that Twitter poll, you can go to our website. It's at News18 and vote. We'll catch you again on the other side of this quick break. Welcome back. Mumbai's killer potholes continue to haunt its citizens, but our netas are too busy playing the blame game rather than actually doing something about it. The ruling Shiv Sena has washed their hands off the issue, saying that there were hardly any potholes on the roads administered by the BMC. Mumbai's mayor, too, is following his party's line, shifting the blame instead onto the Public Works Department, the PWD, under the state government, which is headed by the BJP. It doesn't end there. The PWD minister has also passed the buck, saying that not all of Mumbai's roads are under the PWD's administration. The question we're asking is, who is going to step up and actually fix these roads? The BMC is the richest civic body in the country, and yet the mayor, the man who heads the BMC, continuing to pass the buck.
No matter what claims BMC makes, but these are the allegations that potholes are there, people are meeting with accident, and apart from that, even like in this particular case, BMC ka jo ye bhi jo जहाँ पे चेंबूर में एक औरत का डेथ हुआ वहाँ पे भी उन्होंने बोला कि वो पेड़ का जो कंप्लेन है वो ऑलरेडी दिया गया था बट फिर भी बीएमसी वहाँ पे जाके उन्होंने वो पेड़ को नहीं काटा
दो अलग अलग बातें हैं
जी
पॉट होल्स का अलग बात है और पेड़ गिरा है वो अलग बात है आप मिक्सिंग कर रहे हैं
सर पॉटहोल्स की अगर बात की जाए आपने अभी बोला कि बीएमसी जिन रस्तों को मैनेज करता है वहां पे इतने पॉटहोल्स नहीं है परंतु जो स्टेट गवर्नमेंट जिन रस्तों को मैनेज करता है वो एमएमआरडीए हो या पीडब्ल्यूडी हो उन गड्ढों में ज्यादा पॉटहोल्स है तो क्या आप स्टेट गवर्नमेंट से कुछ अपील करना चाहेंगे कि मेट्रो के काम की वजह से हो या किसी और काम की वजह से हो कि उन रस्तों पे जो पॉटहोल्स है उन लोगों उनको फिल करा जाए
तो उनकी जिम्मेदारी है ना जो उनका रोड है उनकी जिम्मेदारी उन्होंने करना चाहिए जिम्मेदारी निभाना चाहिए
बट आप कह रहे हैं कि बीएमसी अपना काम सही कर रहा है स्टेट गवर्नमेंट ढंग से नहीं कर रहा है
मुझे पता नहीं लेकिन हमारा काम बीएमसी के माध्यम से बीएमसी का काम अच्छे ढंग से चालू है
Meanwhile, the Shiv Sena is unwilling to take up any responsibility, instead attacking the media, attacking CNN News 18 when we questioned them. Party leader Arvind Sawant asked us, why are we only focusing on Mumbai?
The potholes are there politically and potholes are there socially. And potholes are there physically also. Why only target Mumbai? I don't you have a CNN channel, don't you have an issue? If you want to do anything action, you take action against him. I am not against any action. I feel pity of you people also. Do they belong entirely to Mumbai Municipal Corporation? Belong to PWD. And it is in every government. In India, the earlier government was still the same principle. Entire country, show the roads in the entire CNN is not the channel, local channel. We are people down to earth, never ever. This is the way you people are targeting. Are they the people are in the only Mumbai? There are people in the country. There are number of accidents. There are number of deaths in every state. Why only Mumbai? Answer that first.
All right, and finally, Network 18 is proud to be associated with Tata Tea for the Alarm Bajne Se Pehle Jago Re campaign. The campaign is calling for a change of mindset on how we tackle and react to issues related to women's safety in our cities. We urge you to support this campaign by signing a petition on jagore.com to make gender sensitivity compulsory in schools so that children can help build a gender-sensitive and gender-equitable environment. Thanks for tuning in to Face Off. Viewpoint is coming up next.